Today, in this video, we are going to discuss about 21 miracles of Lord Krishna. Mother Devaki had a boon from Lord Vishnu that he will take birth from her womb for 3 births. The first manifestation was Prasnigarbha, who was born to Prajapati Sutapa and Prasni. The Lord had to take the form of Prasnigarbha to appear in front of his devotee Dhruva, who was initiated into Hari Bhakti by Maharshi Narad. The second manifestation was that of Vamana. In the third time, he was born as Lord Krishna. Because of presence of the Lord in her womb, all the celestials and gods and goddesses came to her to offer their worship to the Lord. Lord Vishnu incarnated with lotus eyes, with 4 hands, armed with conch, disc, mace and lotus. Vasudeva praised Lord Vishnu and requested him, "Let me see you as an ordinary child. Withdraw this divine transcendental form, as we are afraid of Kamsa." The Lord assumed the form of handsome baby through the power of his own Maya and ordered that if you are afraid of Kamsa, then take me to Gokula and bring my Maya that is born there of Mother Yashoda immediately. Lord Krishna grew extremely notorious in his childhood. He started stealing milk and butter. Once upon a time, a gopi took hold of Lord Krishna by his hand and went to complain to his mother Yashoda about his mischief. But Lord Krishna miraculously disappeared from her hand, and for her surprise, she found him just near his mother Yashoda. She felt abashed and returned to her house. Lord Sri Krishna received his instructions from his guru Sandipani Muni. Krishna had extremely wonderful retentive memory. He mastered the 64 arts in just 64 days. Lord Krishna led a laborious life. He gathered fuel from the woods for his teacher and he inspired his classmates with his love. He lived with his teacher like an ordinary student and he was extremely humble and obedient. On Ekadashi day, when Nanda was on fast and went to bath in the river Yamuna on Dwadasi, it was still dark in the night. As he entered the river, one of the servants of Lord Varuna seized Nanda and took him to Varuna Loka. When the people realized that Nanda was missing, they informed Lord Krishna in this regard. On hearing them, Lord Krishna entered the water and went to Varuna Loka. There in Varuna Loka, Lord Varuna bowed down to Lord Krishna and apologized to him, saying that his messenger accidentally, unknowingly, has seized and captured Nanda, and requests Lord Krishna to take him back. The gopis in the Vrindavan were none other than the sages in Dandakaranya in their previous incarnation. They wished to embrace Lord Rama when he went on exile. They were promised satisfaction in his later avatar. They finally got blended into Paramatma in the form of avatar of Lord Krishna. After knowing that Lord Vishnu has incarnated as Lord Krishna, Lord Shiva wanted to visit and have his darshan. Lord Shiva came in his natural form with his 3 eyes and matted hair and tiger skin and garland of snakes and knocked at the door of Mother Yashoda. When Lord Shiva asked for darshan of Lord Krishna, Mother Yashoda rejected and sent him empty-handed. As Lord Shiva was left disappointed, Lord Krishna realized it and started crying so badly that it couldn't be controlled by anyone. One among the gopikas named Lalita asked Yashoda, "Did anyone leave the house displeased?" For which Mother Yashoda replied that one sadhu has come to darshan of Lord Krishna, but I did not allow seeing his attire. The gopika named Lalita realized this and left to find him and brought him back home. After the darshan of Lord Krishna, Lord Shiva went into ecstasy of devotion and touched the feet of Krishna to his head and chanted Gopala Sahasranama Stotra. Radha Rani was extremely devoted to Lord Krishna that she could not even control herself at the sight of a cloud or a blue throat of a peacock. It would once awaken in her mind the thought of Lord Krishna and she would instantly go into divine ecstasy. She used to say to her friends, "Once, Lord Krishna gave me a garland. Look, it has withered, but I have not thrown it away yet. Dear friends, I shall not be able to keep my life breath without Lord Krishna. And after my death, place my dead body on a branch of dark Tamala tree and write on my body Lord Krishna's sweet name." Once upon a time, Radharani was called upon to prove her chastity. She was subjected to the ordeal of bringing water in a jar with 1,000 holes in it. She could succeed in doing so without even single drop of water leaking out, and everyone over there applauded her, declaring that such a chaste woman like Radha never was and probably never will be. For this, Radha replied, "Why do you praise me? Instead, glory to Lord Krishna, glory to him alone. I am only handmaid of Lord Krishna." Once, Radha was given hot milk, saying that Lord Krishna gave it to her. She drank it instantly without even giving it time to cool down. But eventually, there were blisters on the feet of Lord Krishna, meaning
the heart of Radha was completely absorbed at the feet of Lord Krishna.
This story speaks about love of Radha to Lord Krishna. When Mother Yashoda could not find Lord Krishna, she approaches Radharani and asks her if she has any news from Lord Krishna. After bowing to Mother Yashoda, Radharani asked the reason of her visit, for which Yashoda stated the reason. Radha asked Mother Yashoda to shut her eyes and meditate upon the form of Lord Krishna. Upon closing her eye, with the help of Radha, Mother Yashoda could have a glimpse of Lord Krishna. Later, Yashoda asked this boon from Radha, "Mother, grant me that I may see my beloved Krishna whenever I close my eyes." One day, among all the gopis, they saw a new gopi among them, and one of them cried in surprise, saying that it was her relative who has been persecuting her, and another one cried that this is her cousin who has been so mean to her. One of the gopis over there has seen their personal enemy in that new gopi, but it is Radha alone who has noticed that it was none other than Lord Krishna who has taken on the different forms, the disguise of all these various people. Then instantly the new gopi changed into the form of Lord Krishna and said, "Radha is extremely blessed, as she is the only one who could see me alone hiding behind all these various disguises." Once upon a time, when Radha had an element of pride in her, Lord Krishna went to her and told her, "Let us run away together." She felt very happy and favored. They walked for a while. Radha was tired and later exhausted, and later complained to Lord Krishna that she cannot walk any further. Lord Krishna said, "All right, do you want me to carry you?" And these words from Krishna pleased Radha. The moment Radha sprang to his back, Lord Krishna disappeared. Radha fell in a heap on the ground. Her pride was shattered. She realized that she cannot possess or control Lord Krishna. She asked for forgiveness. Lord Krishna reappeared and blessed her. She realized that Lord Krishna was not interested in her form, but in her soul. One day, Lord Shiva wanted to take part in Ras Leela of Lord Krishna, but Yogamaya stopped him, saying that only females were to be allowed. When Lord Shiva asked Yogamaya, "How can he get the roop of a gopi?" for which Yogamaya replied, "Seek the shelter of Vrinda Devi. She will grant you the form of gopi." And Vrinda Devi
asked Lord Shiva to take bath in Mansarovar. After bathing there, Lord Shiva emerged out from Mansarovar in the form of a beautiful gopi. Vrinda Devi took Lord Shiva to Rasasthali, where he stood and prayed to Radha Krishna for Prema Bhava. Once the rasa started, the Lord said, "I am not getting the usual pleasure from our Rasleela. Something is not right, and there should be some man among us." Lord Krishna then asked Lalita Devi, one of the gopis, to go and check all the gopis and make sure that there was no man among them. Lalita Devi went around and checked all the gopis, but she could not find any single woman. But she did come across a gopi with three eyes, and later she informed Lord Krishna regarding this. Lord Krishna asked Lalita to bring the three-eyed gopi to him. The moment Lord Krishna saw her, he realized that it was none other than Lord Shiva. Lord Krishna was pleased to see Lord Shiva and offered him the post of Rasadwarapala, and even gave a blessing that all the gopis must offer their worship to him to attain Gopi Bhava. One day, Radha asked Lord Krishna why he loved flute more than her. Lord Krishna replied that this flute is extremely dear to him because it has got a wonderful virtue of emptying its egoism before he could begin to play. It has made its inner hollow quite void so that Krishna can bring about any kind of tune or raga. In the same way, Lord Krishna said to Radha to behave towards him in the same fashion as this flute, and to remove her egoism completely and make perfect self-surrender so that he can love her in the same manner as he loved his flute. When Lord Krishna and Balarama approached their teacher Sandipani Muni in regards with Guru Dakshina, Sandipani Muni asked for the return of his son who has drowned in the ocean of Prabhasa. When Krishna and Balarama approached the ocean, the preceding deity of the ocean advised Lord Krishna that the boy of Sandipani Muni has been captured by the demon Panchajanya. Krishna went deep into the water and killed the demon. Krishna tried to search for son of Sandipani Muni, but he could not find any trace of him. Krishna took the dead body, which was in the shape of a conch, and went to Yama's abode. When Krishna blew his conch shell, Yamaraja appeared and received Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna requested Yamaraja to return his teacher Sandipani Muni's son, and then Krishna and Balarama brought the boy back to his father. At a later period, when Devaki Mata requested Lord Krishna to bring back her dead sons who were killed by Kamsa, just the way he brought back from death the son of his teacher, Lord Krishna, using his yogic powers, brought all the six children from Patala who were killed by Kamsa. Mother Devaki caressed them and breastfed them, and later those six kids attained the abode of celestial plane. One day, Narada wanted to find out how Lord Krishna could lead a happy married life along with his 16,000 wives, for which Narada visited each of their mansions and found Lord Krishna in each of their house, that too engaged in variety of activities. Narada was completely astounded. Even though Lord Krishna was a divine incarnate, he was an embodiment of humility. He became charioteer for Arjuna. Lord Krishna took upon himself the duty of washing the feet of the visitors voluntarily during the Rajasuya Yajna performed by Yudhishthira. This story teaches about the greatness of Brahmacharya of Lord Krishna. Parikshit was a stillborn child. The ladies cried to Lord Krishna to save the child, but Lord said, "If the child be touched by one eternally celibate Nitya Brahmachari, the child would be brought back to life." Nobody dared to touch the child. Even Sukha did not dare. Finding nobody, even among the reputed saints, bold enough to touch the child, Lord Krishna himself went and touched the child, saying, "If I am eternally celibate, may the child be brought back to life." The very instant the baby Parikshit began to breathe, this shows how Lord Krishna, in spite of getting married to 16,000 gopis, could still be eternally brahmachari. Parikshit was protected by Lord Krishna even when he was in the womb from the impact of Brahmastra. One day, Lord Krishna took Arjuna to a certain place where Arjuna could notice a huge tree with huge number of blackberries hanging onto the tree. Then Krishna asked Arjuna to go closer, where Arjuna could see not just clusters of blackberries but innumerable number of Krishnas hanging from the tree. In a way, multiple divine incarnations without number appear and disappear on the tree of Parabrahman. One day, when Lord Krishna and Arjuna were traveling in a chariot, Lord Krishna looked up to the sky and said to Arjuna, "What a nice flight of pigeons over there." Arjuna at once looked in that direction and exclaimed, "Really, very beautiful pigeons indeed." But the next moment, Lord Krishna looked again and said to Arjuna, "No, friend, they are not at all pigeons." Arjuna too instantly looked at the direction and said, "True, they are not pigeons." This doesn't mean Arjuna is lying, but Arjuna had such a faith in Lord Krishna that he verily saw whatsoever Krishna claimed